but they're all melting.
Malcolm's okay for now. I gave him a shot of morphine.
Now, who better to get the children through Jurassic Park than a dinosaur expert? You know, the first attraction I ever built when they came down from Scotland? It's a flea circus, Petticoat Lane. Really quite wonderful. We had a wee trapeze and a carousel. And a seesaw. They all move, motorized, of course, but people would say they could see the fleas. Oh, I can see the fleas, Mummy, can't you see the fleas? Clown fleas and high wire fleas and fleas on parade. This place, I wanted to show them something that wasn't an illusion. Something that was real. Something that they could see, touch. A name not devoid of merit.
But you can't think through this one, John. You have to feel it.
You're right. You're absolutely right. Having Nedry was a mistake. That's obvious. We're over-dependent on automation. I can see that now. Now, the next time everything's corrected, creation is an act of sheer will. Next time it'll be flawless.
It's still the flea circus. It's all an illusion.
When we have control again.
You never had control. That's the illusion. I was overwhelmed by the power of this place. But I made a mistake, too. I didn't have enough respect for that power, and it's out now. The only thing that matters now are the people you love. Alan and Lex and Tim. John, they're out there where people are dying. So... good.
Spared no expense.
There's a really first-rate shot of the deck of this ship and the cargo hold that, for the moment anyway, contains the animal itself, presumably with the infant alongside. Now, by our calculations, they should be nearing the halfway point of this trip. Jim, can you still hear me there?
Yes, I can, Bernard. We are, in fact, halfway to the island. It is 206 nautical miles from our present location. The ship is moving at about 20 knots, which will put it in at about 11:30 a.m. Eastern time. One of the Navy's primary concerns through all of this has been safety. And if we take another look around the ever-growing escort around the ship, they are taking no chances of a repeat of the San Diego incident.
Okay, we're going to take a moment here and run the tape of our interview earlier today with John Hammond. He's the former head of engine bioengineering, the man who has come forward to spearhead this movement, not only to return these animals to their island, but to keep the island itself intact.
It is absolutely imperative that we work with the Costa Rican Department of Biological Preserves to establish a set of rules for the preservation and isolation of that island. These creatures require our absence to survive, not our help. And if we could only step aside and trust in nature, life will find a way.
did it, honey. We're here.
Cooper, if you see anything, yell up.
No, I thought I'd keep it to myself.
I'm sorry. Look, everyone, if you look out the left of the plane, you can see a whole herd of brachiosaurs. In fact, you can see in the front of the group, the alpha male grazing there.
Udesky, Dash, how about up front? You guys see anything?
Nothing yet, Mr. Kirby.
Mrs. Kirby, look. Out here, you'll see a group of triceratops.
Mr. Kirby, we have a landing strip up ahead. You want me to put it down?
No. I told you, I want to circle first, see the whole island.
You need to set it down. You can't land here. What are you talking about?
Hold on. I can explain.
Well, you cannot land on this island.
Dr. Grass, can you
worry?
Please,
Dr.
Grass.
Please, sit down. Wait. Dr. Grass, will you please sit down?
Thank you.